गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे अगेन वी विल बी कवरिंग द लेसन प्राइमरी एक्टिविटीज, लेसन नंबर 5 फ्रॉम बुक नंबर 1। टुडेज टॉपिक इज फैक्ट्री फार्मिंग, कोऑपरेटिव फार्मिंग एंड कलेक्टिव फार्मिंग। नाउ व्हाट इज फैक्ट्री फार्मिंग? यू माइट हैव नेवर हर्ड ऑफ फैक्ट्री फार्मिंग। इट इज इंक्लूडेड इन योर मिक्स्ड फार्मिंग एंड हॉर्टिकल्चर एंड आफ्टर ट्रक फार्मिंग न्यू टाइप ऑफ फार्मिंग हैज बीन इंट्रोड्यूस्ड दैट इज नोन एज द फैक्ट्री फार्मिंग। नाउ व्हाट इज फैक्ट्री फार्मिंग? This actually developed in the industrial regions of Western Europe and North America near the industries. Now, here poultry and livestock rearing is being carried on. These animals or the poultry and livestock are fed on factory feedstuff. That is, whatever is being made in the factory and whatever waste is left, that is fed to these poultry and livestock and carefully supervised so that no diseases are being gone to the animals. Then heavy capital investment, that means lot of money is required in this in terms of veterinary services, that is in the treatment of the animals, heating and lighting process. Then the most important feature of factory farming is the breed selection and the scientific breeding, that is the best breeds are being chosen and then scientific breeding is done of these animals. I hope this topic is clear to you. Now next we are coming to cooperative farming. Now what is cooperative farming? A group of farmers pool their resources for efficient and profitable farming. That means there are few 5-6 farmers who are coming together, they put in their resources. What are their resources? Their resources is the land and you can say the capital investment. They pool in all their resources and they come together to have an efficient and profitable farming. That is, everybody is being given a profitable share. Individual farm remains intact. That means, supposing I am having a farm, that farm will be with me and my neighbor's farm is also with him or her. Farming is a matter of cooperative initiative. That means whatever resources we are having, we cooperate it together, mix them together and then farming is done. Societies help farmers in getting agricultural inputs, sell products. Now what is the societies helping? If there is cooperative farming, these societies help the farmers in getting agricultural inputs. That is, agricultural machinery is being got. Then process, help in processing of quality products at cheaper rates. Quality is being given at a very low price and you can say the products are sold in terms of favorable terms. Products are sold at favorable terms. That is, on the terms of the individual or the farmer, the product is being sold. It is not the middleman which is having its, his wishes. It is the farmer who is having the wishes. And it is mostly practiced in the Denmark, Netherlands, Belgium, Sweden and Italy. Now coming to the third, we have collective farming. Now what is collective farming? It is a social ownership for means of production and labor. Society is coming together as a whole and production and labor is combined together. Here it is also known as kolkhoz. What is kolkhoz? It was introduced in the erstwhile Russia. It started in USSR before it got divided into different countries, or it was known as kolkhoz. Then farmers pool in their resources like land, livestock and labor. Again same like cooperative farming, they pool in their resources. Here also collective farming, they pool in their resources such as land, labor and livestock. They are allowed to, in this, they are allowed to retain a small land to grow their own crops. For themselves, the farmers are given a small part of that particular land so that they can grow their own crops. And on the other part or the major part, everything what is grown is taken by the government. They are allowed to retain, yearly targets are fixed by the governments. The government fixed the target that this much amount of production needs to be done every year. then government fixes the product rates. Whatever the product is being produced, that rate is being fixed by the government. Whereas in cooperative farming, it was the farmer who was fixing the rates. Here the government is fixing the rates. Next, excess is distributed among the farmers. If it is not required, the excess is distributed among the farmers. Farmers pay taxes for their own land. Here the biggest you can say the drawback is the farmers, they have their own land and they have to pay the taxes for their own land. Okay, then members are paid according to their nature of work. If you are a laborer or the owner, accordingly you are paid the money by the government. Then the most you can say exceptional work is rewarded by the government. Government awards those exceptional work or the more production is done or something very you can say exceptionally well has happened, the government rewards the you can say the work. I hope these three topics are clear with you in agriculture. Thank you.